He's had a great year so far. It's been even better. And he came to me and he said, I don't know whether I should preach or not, I can't. Preaching we do every year. Teaching we do every year. Every year. And music contests we do every year. And the judges judge and all that kind of stuff. And he said, Gordon, I don't know whether I should do this year. I don't know if you know, God's calling me to do that. And I said, what do you want to do? And he said, I kind of want to. I said, well, what's the excuse? And he saw some stuff from Louis Digo, which is a fantastic teacher and preacher. And he was talking to me one night, and I said, that's great, Jordan, I love the theme, but make it yours. And he did a great job of making it his, so I'm going to let him preach it.
You think of David, and honestly, David in the Bible, I go, heard my voice into his temple, and my cry came before him, even to his ears. And that's David right there. You know, David, he struggled a lot. And so, you know, Saul tried to kill David several times. And now, I don't know what it feels like to have someone out there tell you what I'm doing. It's not a great feeling. I mean, each night, David ran from place to place, trying to find refuge, and trying to get away from Saul. And every person that gave David refuge, Saul killed. But, you know, you think, David probably lost it. But to be honest, he didn't. I mean, he was struggling, but he always put his trust in God, and God took care of him and helped him find. You know, and then later on, Saul got killed, and then David became this wonderful king, but his problems were just starting. David focused on more of the stuff he could have rather than what he did have, and idolized a lot of things, which hurt him. He committed adultery with Bathsheba and later killed her husband to cover it all up. David's son also tried to kill David to take over his kingdom. And he had so many family blows, and it's like, how did David stand it? How did he get through this? I can kind of relate to him, because in like a little time, everything changed for him. But no matter all through his sins and everything he went through, David knew that God was there. And he never really found rest in his trials, but he put rest in God. God picked him up. David, I have. How great is our God? And you know, you look at David's life, and he gained it all, but lost so much. And, you know, he took David and held him in his hand, and no matter what David would go through, God always reminded him that he was right there. I mean, our God is so big that it doesn't matter what storm we're going through, our God has us in his hand. And this is what God says here in Hebrews 13:5-6. I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Though he may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do. I mean, right there, God says, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. And it's awesome to think, because whether you know it or not, God, and whatever you're going through, God is right there. I mean, it doesn't matter what I'm going through, what you're going through, God's with you all the time. He's right here with you. He's right in the house. And he's with us through it all. And our God is a strong, loving, powerful, everlasting God that never leaves our side. No matter what we are going through, even me, God is taking care of us, and he can withstand anything. And almost done, but a couple months ago, I was just driving down 29, I live in a Broadrun Baptist church, and there's a sign on the church, and I was just driving to get things off my mind. And on the sign, I'll never forget this quote: don't tell God how big your storm is, tell your storm how big your God is. And it is so awesome to hear that, because it doesn't matter how big my problem is or how big your problem is, God is totally taking care of you. And he can be anything. When I was a kid, I remember watching VeggieTales. God is bigger than the boogeyman. When I was a kid, I was scared of the boogeyman. And maybe kids are not too. But God is bigger than that. And God is bigger than any storm you may face right now. And again, in Psalms 18:2, the Lord is my rock and my fortress, and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler, and the horn of my salvation, my high tower. At the end of the day, I keep thinking, how great is our God? He holds me every step of the way. He makes miracles happen in a flash.